Hey folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and here are what I believe to be 6 of the best mini amps you can get in 2021 that don't suck. Every guitar player out there, at some point in your guitar playing career, you have to own a mini amp. It's just like a rite of passage, everyone's got to have a mini amp. Number one, they make great little ornaments, they just look fantastic. They make great gifts as well for the guitarists in your life if you want to treat yourself. They're really handy to have as well, like if you go, say, camping with a family, or you've got to spend some time in a hotel room, or you go on holiday or something like that. A nice little battery-powered amp, just to kind of scratch that electric guitar itch. They're known for being very uniquely sounding. They're all very small amps, and they're all not a lot of money. Well, a couple of them are quite. I threw some curveballs in this list of 2021, because there was a separate video I did a couple of years ago, best mini amps, and the like original lot are included in that. These are a bit more, left field, let's say. Like, I got the whole stack this time with the Marshall instead of the little stack, and some crazy headphones that you'll find in a second. With that though, the reason only own a mini amp is they have their own unique tone. A lot of bands, like Queens of the Stone Age and stuff, mic up these amplifiers and crank them to high heaven, and you get a really quirky, fuzzy, mangled sound out of it. It's a very, very unique sound. And Alex, the videographer guy, just sat down there. Hello, Alex.
Hello.
He was saying that he went to see a band when he was growing up. At the Academy or somewhere. Where was it?
It was the Academy.
It was the Academy. And they had one of these amps mic'd up going into the speaker system just to make it sound like a really quirky little thing. So every guitar player out there has to own a little mini amp. In this video, I have offerings from Marshall, Fender, Boss, and some lovely little bright Blackstar goodies. I'm playing this Kramer Charlie Paris Signature Vanguard through 2SX cables. They're all mic'd up with a Lewis MTP440. All the links are in the description box down below for all the prices and all the details that I miss in this video. And while you're down there, hit subscribe and give this video a like. Right, let's get started with this ridiculous thing. This is a Marshall MS4. It's a little stack of awesomeness. Expecting to hear a 1971 Marshall Super Lead when you plug into one of these. It's just that it's a small mini amp and it scratches the itch and it looks fantastic. As a guitar player that likes daft, nerdy things, this is the one I would go for. You can get the smaller version, the MS2, which I included in the previous list of cheap, awesome mini amps, but this is the stack and it's awesome, super easy to use. It's only 1 watt, powered by either a 9-volt battery or a 9-volt power supply, the same ones that you find on your pedal board. Two little speakers, 3 controls up top, a gain control for how much saturation you want, a volume control, how loud you want it, and a tone control for how loud, light, or how bright or dark you want your tone to be, and the on-off switch over there on the right. You plug it at the bottom left, there's a headphone output on the right, or like a line out, so you can go into like a big PA system in an Academy, and it is what it is, it's a tiny Marshall and it's awesome. Those kind of really mid-focus Marshall-y tones, it's just tiny and it's got its own unique tone, let's just say that. It hasn't got a clean tone, a clean setting, let's say, like a clean channel, but it's kind of more inclined to be like an old Marshall. So you just turn the gain down or the volume on your guitar to clean it up. Crank the gain now to get that unique mini amp sound. So this is 10 o'clock. It starts to distort because it's only a tiny little speaker and there's a lot of 1 watt Marshall goodness hitting those tiny speakers. This is the tone that like Queens of the Stone Age use. The Black Keys always use these little amps as well, cranked. That's why I think the Marshall MS4 is one of the best mini amps of 2021. Just look at it! This is the Fender Mini Tone Master, and it looks just fantastic. If you're a Fender guy, this is for you. If you're a Marshall guy, that's for you. I think I prefer the tone of this. I don't know, initially, before we get to the rest of the main, let me know what you think down below in the comments. This or the Marshall MS4? So this is a little 1 watt amplifier, two inch speakers. One gain control, a volume control, a tone control, and an on-off switch. Very similar to the Marshall, but it has got a different tone. Headphone output runs on a 9-volt battery or a 9-volt power supply. The original Tone Masters came out in the 90s, the big ones. They were copying the old Band Masters from the 60s for this kind of aesthetic. Tonally, this isn't really like a Band Master. It's just a mini amp, but it delivers. It looks cool. Both this and the Marshall have little backstops on them, so you can lean them back to get them hitting directly in your face on a table or something. Here's some more tones. Tone's halfway up. Gain's at 10 o'clock for now. Clean sound, just roll that volume down. Turn up that gain because we can. This is 2 o'clock. Yeah, quite a lot of sustain and saturation. I was gonna get the feedback for a second there. Crazy overtones there, wasn't it? Throw the gain back. Play with some tone. This is a brighter sound. And a darker sound. Darker sound is definitely more vintage sounding, isn't it? That's the Fender Mini Tone Master. This amazing little thing is a Blackstar Fly 3. And I included one of these in the original best mini amps that don't suck video from a couple of years ago. But now they come in so many other different colours. That was when they were first released. Now you can get them in neon pink. As you can see, there's Day of the Dead variants. There's old school vintage looking ones. But I'm me, and I really enjoy this neon pink with neon green logo and neon green knobs. I use one of these personally. I always use this as my practice amp in the house when I don't want to annoy the neighbours. Blackstar Fly. Not this though, a little regular black one, but they're so cool. I just wanted to talk about how awesome they actually are for the size and for the price. There's bass versions, there's acoustic versions, there's Bluetooth versions where you can Bluetooth like backing tracks to it and play along with your phone. These do have auxiliary ins though, so you can plug your phone in the old-fashioned way and play along that way. There's a headphone output, a volume control, a gain control, and a tone control. It actually has two channels, this amp, so there's a clean and a distortion sound, and that lovely vintage tape echo that you just heard there with its own level, how loud you want it, and time, how long you want the delay to be. It's got much more of an amp-like tone. It's got that kind of, you can really dig in. Let's turn off that delay, because you know what the delay sounds like now. So you can get the full effect of the Blackstar. So that's the gain halfway up. Let's turn the gain down before we hear some clean stuff. Quarter of the way up. When you crank it, you do get pretty metally, which is great. It doesn't like fizz and distort like the quirky nature of the Fender and that Marshall stack. Clean tones though. Listen to those little bit of some cleans with the gain halfway up. Turn in some more delay. See what this has to offer. Go from that all the way to with the Blackstar Fly 3, and now you can get it in fabulous neon pink. Look at it, it's my favorite, it's great. Get one. This amazing thing is the Boss Katana Air. Now this is a bit more pricey, quite a bit more pricey, but it does a lot more than the rest of the mini amps in this video. I've already done so much content on the Yamaha THR amps, so this is kind of Boss's version of that. Tonally, they're very different and they all do different things. If you're familiar with the Boss Katana, it's one of the best-selling digital modeling amps of all time. When that was released, for the price, what it could do, and how it sounded, nothing can kind of touch it. It kind of leveled the playing field. And this is that, but in a tiny little portable version. And when I say it portable, it's powered either by a power plug socket thing or by 8 AA batteries. So you can actually take it around and transport it. And with that, wireless receiver. So it comes with a beautiful little Boss WL20, I think they're called, wireless transmitter, which is rechargeable in the top of it, and you can get 12 hours battery life and cut about totally wirelessly. I'm away, I'll see you there. Get back. But yes, you can do a lot with this amplifier. Sam already has a whole video. I'll just be looking at that camera. You can do a whole lot with this amplifier. Sam from PMTVUK already has a full rundown on this amplifier where he goes to a beach and cuts about wirelessly. So I'm not going to go massively in-depth. I'll link that down below. Watch that if you want the full in-depth thing on this amplifier. But one more little thing about this wireless, right? So this is obviously rechargeable through the top like I've been harping on about. But it's also, one, motion sensored. So two, when you put your guitar down and you accidentally leave this in your guitar, it's not going to drain the battery. It'll turn off when it realizes that the guitar isn't getting played, so it can save the battery that way. There's also a tiny little nubbin on it, which can tell when it's pressed into the guitar and tell when it's pulled out. So that will stop any unwanted, like bangs and cracks when you pull your guitar cable in and out. It's going to stop all that. Very, very fancy. 3-band EQ, loads of tones from acoustic preamps. You can use it with acoustic guitar. Crunch sounds if you want to sound like AC/DC. Clean sounds if you want to sound like Stevie Ray Vaughan. And metal sounds if you want to sound like Slayer and stuff. Lots of beautiful built-in effects. There's a 3-band EQ. And There's lots of effects. This has Bluetooth capability. That's another lovely bit why it's wireless. So you can Bluetooth this to your phone and go to the Boss Tone Center app and control parameters within this wirelessly through your phone. So it's got 50 or 60 Boss iconic pedals available anyways. I think it's like 8 built into it, but you can chop and change to whatever you want, from overdrives, phasers, flanges, delays, octavers, and everything in between. You can store 6 presets in it with the banks. There's 2 banks, bank 1, bank 2. There's 3 colors through each, green, orange, and red. Use the control panel, headphone output, auxiliary in. You can do a lot. Let's just play with some sounds so you can hear why this is one of the best mini amps of 2021, okay? That's on the brown sound. See that a crunch? Turn the delay off, actually. So there's delay, there's other effects like wah, auto wahs and octaves and stuff. There's boosts, so you can like add a Boss's variant of a tube screamer or an SD1 or something, as well as lots of reverb. Turn the delay off. Bit of reverb just to give you more tone of the amp. Let's go through the presets, what have been pre-saved in the Katana Air. So channel A, green. This is a clean sound. It's lovely and ethereal. This is totally stereo, by the way, so the stereo effects kind of fill the entire room, and yeah, it's gorgeous. That's very kind of. Awesome. Third one. Oh, it's an auto wah. Who doesn't love that? 3 more. Let's check it out. This is orange on B. I think channel B is more metal focused. Quite a lot of grit in there. And back to manual. Clean sounds now, because there wasn't a lot of clean sounds, this is just the general clean tone. So that is why the Boss Katana Air is amazing, why it's one of the best little mini amps of 2021, and why you should buy one. Love this thing. This is the Fender Mustang Micro, and it's an amazing bit of kit from 2021. Usually, you plug this into your guitar and run some headphones with it so you can practice silently and get some amazing and classic Fender tones, loads of effects and loads of modern tones. But this, for the sake of this, I've got a wire running out into an audio interface coming through some speakers, which is getting recorded and then going into your lovely ears. I'm blown away by this thing. It's absolutely unbelievable. Piece of tech. So in the box, it's like getting an Apple product. It's an awesome thing. So there is a 65 twin with a compressor, there's a 65 Fender Deluxe, a 57 twin, a 60s British amplifier, which is something like, I don't know, we can't see it on the thing, 70s British, 90s American, bass breaker, an FBE 100, which I think is probably a Friedman, Metal 2000, an Uber amp, and a Studio preamp, and effects. All the beautiful reverb you could ever imagine from all the most iconic Fender amps and a lot of tremolo stuff, as well as, obviously, there's choruses, there's, let's close this box, there's choruses, there's phases, there's flanges, there's a lot, and they're all controlled by these little buttons on the sides. You can scroll through the amps, scroll through the different EQ settings, so you can have, like, they're all preset lovely EQ settings, so push mids, scoot mids, a bit of bass, a bit of treble. I haven't managed to get a bad sound out of it yet, it sounds fantastic, and obviously all the effects. Let's just randomly kick some buttons and see what happens, okay? That was bloody great for what it is, isn't it? Imagine just silently practicing with that, come through your headphones. Totally stereo as well. USB rechargeable. I think you can get 5 hours? 6 hours? Can't remember. It's all linked in the description box down below. Charge out of it. And you can USB it directly into your computer as well. So you can get the tones from this directly, like as if it was an, use this as an audio interface and get your guitar tones into GarageBand or Cubase or whatever you use. Got some phaser or chorus, nice chorus. You got a purple rain, haven't you? That's a hard song to play. More amps, let's have a little fiddle. So they're all color-coded inside the box, all the amps that you're using. intense. What amp set? That is a bass breaker on high gain, a bass breaker 15, so not even one of the most intense metal amps you can get out of this. This is a Fender amp, which has a lot of gain in it. This is a Freeman. Some more effects, what we can get. Purple effects, slapback delay, and a large room reverb. Perfect for a metal tone, isn't it? Two two nine zero delay even. That's good. Then back to your lovely. All the amp models and effects are taken from Fender's extremely popular, critically acclaimed Mustang series of amplifiers. As the name suggests, this is the Mustang Micro. And it's also Bluetooth compatible, so you can Bluetooth your phone to this and play along with some awesome backing tracks. It's such an amazing piece of kit. Let's get some more tones before we move on to the last one. I love this little thing, it's fantastic. This has been the Mustang Micro in all of its glory. Now last but certainly not least, we have something which I can't actually demo for you guys. It's the Boss Waza Air headphones. I could demo them for you, but every demo I've seen online has been pretty crap at explaining how amazing they actually are. So hopefully you'll just take my word for it and recognize that these are some of the most game-changing things you will ever try on. You need to try them on to realize how amazing they are. They're a bit pricey. They're all pricier than the rest of the small amps, but if you don't know what these are a Boss Katana for your head, for your like headphones, in headphones. It's absolutely crackers, but it's more than just playing along with your guitar and hearing your guitar. It has spatial awareness. There's a gyro in this to So the best way I can describe it, right, is you choose an amplifier. There's 5 unique voicings in this taken from the Boss Katana. You heard the Katana Air before, and over 50 Boss effects. So you can do a lot of tones with it, but that's not the selling point. It sounds great, fantastic, regardless. You can place an amp somewhere in a room, okay? So you can, it comes with a little receiver, the same Boss one as the Katana Air. Goes in there, put your headphones on. You can virtually place an amplifier in the room and face it with your headphones on. And when you turn away with the headphones on, the amp will move behind you and be, you could run away like across a football field or something, and you will be still able to hear your amp in the distance, getting more and more spatial aware, and the reverb will continue because you're further away from the actual amplifier. All that, almost virtual reality in your headphones, which is just mind-boggling. As soon as you try these, everyone I know that's seen try them on has bought them in the end, because the tones are fantastic. It's the Katana tones, of course, it's going to be great, but it's that, what do they call it? Amp in room tone? It's not very dramatic, is it? But it's the amp in room tone. It sounds like you're playing with an amplifier and you can virtually move around it and get closer or get further away. But my favorite thing, which I did a lot during quarantine, was you can play on with backing tracks. So I Bluetoothed, because you can Bluetooth this, you can change all the beautiful parameters within this, like all the amps and effects and bass, middle and treble and stuff with the Boss Tone Studio app, Bluetooth to your phone and do all that. You can play along with backing tracks, Bluetoothly. So I put on the backing track of a live AC/DC concert, and spatial awareness put the band behind you. So you can hear the band behind you, and you can move your amp behind you, and you can play along in your living room, looking at yourself in the mirror. And it sounds like you've got Malcolm Young and Angus Young, Brian Johnson and Cliff Williams and all that behind you. It's an amazing thing. You get to play along with bands, get the band to move around. You can face the speakers, you can turn away from the speakers, all this whilst getting great tones from the Waza Air. I can't try them because they can't do, you can't do it justice when you try them in videos. And you try them out for yourselves. I highly recommend saving up and getting a set of the Boss Waza Air headphones. They will blow your mind. So there we have it, ladies and gents, six of what I believe to be the best mini amps, some of them are a bit of a stretch for a mini amp, available in 2021. Some of this tech these days is absolutely astounding. I can't wait to see where the boat, where the envelope gets pushed further into the future. Comment down below your favorite, which one sounded the best, which one, I was gonna say which one sounded the worst. The Marshall was probably the most fuzzy, but it has such a beautiful tone, and the history of bands using it live and on stage. It's just a great thing to have, and it looks the coolest, in my humble opinion. But let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTVUK on YouTube for lots of more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on any of the amplifiers I spoke about today in this video, they're all linked in the description box down below. Get yourself to PMTOnline.co.uk or call into one of our forever expanding lovely PMT stores. We are PMT House of Rock on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter and now TikTok. Give us a like and a follow to see pictures of them with nice filters on. I've been Dagan and I'll see you next time.